praise the Lord. No response. No response. Amen. Praise the Lord. Can we stand up to honor our God? There is time for everything. When we finish service, we will have opportunity to chat with each other. Amen. We just want to bless the name of the living God today, because he has made it possible for us to be alive in the land of the living. I'm reading from Psalm 95. Oh, come, let us sing unto the Lord. Let us make a joyful noise to the rock of our salvation. There is a call to worship the Lord, a call to make a joyful noise unto the Lord. If you read down, you will discover why we must do that. It's not by choice, because we've made the first choice of knowing him and who he is. So it is our own duty to come to worship him, to give honor that is due for him, to him, to bow down before him, to reference his suffering thing, and to show him how far we love him, and to appreciate his goodness and his mercies unto us. Because we know there are so many people that started their journey last Monday as we started. They ended on the road, some of them ended at the hospitals. But to us, look at how beautiful we are to be in the presence of the living God. So consecrate yourself, concentrate, and forget about every disappointment of the week, every hassles of the week. Forget about everything. Focus your totality in the presence of the living God. Join the angels. I'm telling you what I know, what I've proved. Join the angels in spirit. Focus your totality. Imagine how great our God is. How the angels are surrounding the throne, bowing down before him, singing, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty." Brethren, this is why we are here. We have come to join them, to connect our totality above, to worship him, to show him how far, how much we love him. Because he's our great God. He has been granting us many mercies. He has been providing for our needs. He has been showing mercies unto us. He has been healing our diseases. He has been directing our paths. He has been protecting us from all evils. This is why we must open our mouths to show him that we love him. Show him that you 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 love him. We love you, Jesus. Jesus, we love you for dying for us. God, we love you for your protections upon our lives, for your provisions, for the healing power. Jesus, we love you for dying on the cross of Calvary. Jesus, we love you for forgiving and cleansing our sins. Bless the Lord. Bless the Lord. God, we bless you. We join the host of heaven. We join your angels to bow down before you, to worship you. We love you. We pray, Jehovah, according to your word, that when we gather together, the blood of Jesus cleanses us from all our iniquities. Let the blood of Jesus flow. Let the blood of Jesus flow. Flow in our tongues. flow in our hearts, flow in our totality, to cleanse us, to forgive us, to purify us, to prepare us. Blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus, blood of Jesus. Father, we commit every instrument you're going to use. We pray that your Holy Spirit will direct you, God. Our coming today, we decree and declare, it's not going to be in vain. We will never go back as we came. We pray, oh God, for your touch. We pray for your visitation. We pray, oh God, Jehovah, for the angels to fellowship with us. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus.
Jesus, we exalt you, Jesus. We make a joyful noise to your holy name. We give our best shout to you, Jesus. You deserve the praise. You deserve the worship. Oh, we love you, Jesus. We honor your name. Hallelujah. There is none like you, Lord God. So we shout to your holy name. My Jesus, my Savior, Lord, there is none like you. All of my days, and I want to praise the wonders of your mighty God. You are my comfort, Lord. My comfort, my shelter, tower of refuge and strength. Let every breath, every creation, let every creation make a joyful noise.
Never cease to worship.
My Jesus. We are so excited, Lord, to meet you, Lord God, face to face, Lord Jesus, where there are no more sufferings, where there are no more tears, no more pain, Lord Jesus. Only you, Lord God, day and night worshiping you, Lord God. Hallelujah, with our loved ones. Hallelujah, with the billions, with the uncountable number, Lord God, of holy ones, Lord Jesus. Almighty ones, hallelujah, come and bless him. Come on, and bless him. Bless the Lord, Almighty Ones.
Lord, Almighty Ones. Bless the Lord, you heavenly host. Bless the Lord, all you his angels, and let all the earth sing for his praise.
Bless the Lord.
Lord, Almighty Ones, bless the Lord, you heavenly hosts.
Bless the Lord,
bless the Lord, all you his angels,
and let it all the earth,
and let all the earth sing for
you. Come on, come on, come on.
Come on, come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name. Come on, come on and bless him. Come on, come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name. Come on, come on and bless him.
Come on.
Come on, come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name. Come on, come on and bless him. Come on, come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name. Come on, come on and bless him.
Hey! Let's give God our best love.
Bless the Lord, Almighty Ones. Bless the Lord,
you heavenly host.
Bless the Lord, all you his angels.
And let all the earth sing for his praise.
Come on.
Come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name. Come on, come on and bless him. Come on, come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name. Come on, come on and bless him. Come on, come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name. Come on, come on and bless him. Come on, come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name. Come on, come on and bless him.
For the Lord.
For the Lord delights in showing mercy. For the Lord delights in showing mercy. For the Lord delights in showing mercy. For the Lord delights in showing mercy.
This time, let's try to move our body. Let's try to move our tongue. Let's try to lift our hands. Let's clap our hands.
When I move my body, when I move my feet, when I open my mouth, then the darkness flee. When I move my body, when I move my feet, when I open my mouth, then the darkness flee. When I move my body, when I move my feet, when I open my mouth, then the darkness flee. When I move my body, when I move my feet, when I open my mouth, then the darkness flee. When I move my body, when I move my feet, when I open my mouth, then the darkness flee. When I move my body, when I move my feet, when I open my mouth, then the darkness flee.
Hey! Move, move, move. Move, move, move. Move, move, move. My praise is a weapon.
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 My dance 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 is a weapon.
My shout is a weapon.
My shout is a weapon.
My shout.
My shout.
My shout.
My shout.
My shout is a weapon.
My shout is a weapon.
My shout is a weapon.
My shout.
My shout.
My shout.
My shout. My clap is a weapon.
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 Let's sing, hey, 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 with one voice. Hey, 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 hey. Strongholds are coming down. Jesus is lifted high. Strongholds are coming down. Jesus, do this action. Strongholds are coming down. Jesus is lifted high. Strongholds are coming down.
Jesus is lifted high.
Satan is coming down. Jesus is lifted high.
Jesus is lifted high.
Satan is coming down.
Satan is coming down.
Jesus is lifted high.
Jesus is lifted high.
Jesus is lifted high.
Jesus is lifted high.
Jesus is lifted
high.
Jesus is lifted high.
Jesus is lifted high.
My praise is a weapon.
My praise is a weapon.
My dance is a weapon.
My dance is a weapon.
My shout is a weapon.
My shout is a weapon.
My shout is a weapon.
My shout.
My shout.
My shout.
My shout.
For the Lord delights in showing.
For the Lord delights in showing mercy.
For the Lord delights in showing mercy.
Oh Jesus, we give you our best shout for all your goodness, Lord. The word of Psalm says, what can I repay to the Lord for all the benefits that he has for me? I lift up my cup of salvation and call upon the name of the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You are so glorious. You are so glorious, Lord. Oh Jesus, be lifted high upon this. Hallelujah. Every strongholds are now broken down in the name of Jesus. Every sickness, you depart upon this place. Hallelujah. This is the place only for the glory of God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. You are glorious.
Yeah.
I stand.
To whom all praise is due, I stand. grace and His mercy new every morning. The sun may not rise up sometimes. The sun may not be shining. The weather may be changed. But His grace is new every morning, the Bible says. That way, always, it's important, people of God, that we stand in the hour of God. We stand in the hour of Jesus. When we connect with Him, tell Him, Lord, that Your mercy, Your grace, that alone is leading me. There's nothing else in me to consider, O God, my Lord. That Your mercy, hallelujah. I'm going to speak unto God. Tell Him, Lord, I stand in awe of You, God. You are beautiful beyond description. There is no word that we can, Lord God, explain the things of God, hallelujah. That beyond everything, John, he write the gospel. And in the end, John is writing like this. Apostle John, he is saying, if I can write everything that Jesus done, this world will not contain with the books, hallelujah. That is what our Lord is, hallelujah. Nobody can explain. Nobody can, hallelujah, think about the goodness of God. My beloved people of God, it is important that you and me, we meditate over Him. And we declare to this morning that I stand in awe of You, God, my Lord. I stand in awe of You, God, hallelujah. Lift your hand towards heaven. Tell Him, Lord, I stand in awe of You, God, my Father. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Mighty You are, my God, my Father. You are holy. Your mercy endureth forever, God, my Lord, God, my Father. You are righteous. You are righteous, God, my Lord, God, my Father. We lift You on higher, King of kings and the Lord of lords. The great that I am, that I am. Come on, church, bring your own song to God. Hallelujah. Mighty You are, hallelujah. The name that's the name of all names. Uraba Sadala Bokura Babalandira.
Holy You are, Your mercy endures.
Do you believe that His mercy endures forever? Oh, hallelujah. He's righteous.
Righteous You are.
He's great.
Exalt You, O Lord, my God, my King.
You're mighty, O God, my Lord.
O mighty You are, and holy You are. Your mercy endureth forevermore. And righteous You
for a man, you're clapping for Jesus. In a way, He will clap for Him. In a way, you will open your mouth and tell Him, Lord, I love You. Lord, I praise You. Lord, I exalt You. Lord, I lift You on higher regard, my Lord God. Urama sadala bakura baba balandira. Ira basada bakuro. Ira balandira bakura baba balandi. Ira basada bakura. Hallelujah. Yes, yes, yes. Hallelujah. Kuru, Ira Baba, Kura Baba, Hande, Nira Bakuru, Sadana Baba, Nira Bakura Baba, Hande. Oh, we praise your holy name, praise your mighty name, exalt in the highest of God, my Lord God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Ura Baba, Sadana Bakuru, Ira La Bakura Baba, Baba, Nira Bakuru, Nira Bakura Baba, Baba, Hande. Yes, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. We exalt you in the highest of God, my Lord. Hallelujah. This morning, we declare, let this nation exalt the name of Jesus. Let the nation of Ireland bow before the name of God. Oh, hallelujah. We can sense these days, there's a lot of changes that is happening over the nation for the goodness of God. The Lord is turning things upside down. Hallelujah, for His divine glory. Let's pray the Lord's glory will hit upon the city and over the nation in Jesus' name. Can I ask Brother Blaise to lead us in prayer? So, Lord, brother, pray. Let's all join together. If you're able to kneel down before the throne of God. Otherwise, you can stand and intercede for the nation and for the city in Jesus' Amen. Mighty name.
Hallelujah.
Thank yes, Lord you, Father. God, Thank my Father. Oh, King of glory. Hallelujah. The mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Yes, oh God, my Father.
Oh, Father, Lord, we give you glory. We lift you.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father, to be in your presence this morning. Happy to be in your presence, Father, Lord. Oh, Father, there's none like you, Father. You are a healer, our provider, Father, Lord. Oh, Father, take over control, Father, the many days we have, Father. Because you gather us, Father, Lord. Monday, Tuesday, Friday, today. We are here this morning, Sunday, Father, Lord. Praise and lift up your name, Father, Lord. Oh, Father, Lord. Glory to your name, Father, Lord. Thank you, Father, Lord, for everything, Father, Lord. Ah, we thank you also, Father, for those who don't make it this morning. God, you will sustain them. Whatever they are, Father, Lord. Oh, Father, Lord, in the hospital, Father. Give it thanks, Father. Give them mindful things for doctors, Father, too. And they be discharged, Father, Lord, this 2024, Father, Lord. Glory be on your name. And this country republic of Ireland, Father, Lord. Take over control, Father, Lord, of everything, Father. To be in favor, Father. They can take grace, Father, and follow the way of Christ, Father, Lord. Because without you, we are nothing, Father, Lord. Oh, Father, Lord, thanks for everything. Thank you, Father Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, million time. We yes. Everlasting, Father Lord. We are going to give you thanks for everything, Father Lord. Yes. During all the remaining days of our life, Father Lord. Amen. Thank you, Father, for everything, Father Lord. Hallelujah. We are here before you this morning yes, to glorify God. Everything you have done, Father, upon our life. Glorify everything you have done for the ministry of Jesus. Amen. We continue to follow up, Father Lord. Hallelujah. And the ministry of Jesus will continue to grow up, yes. Father Lord. Grow up more, Father, in this country, Republic of expand beyond, Father, our expectation, Amen. Father Lord. Oh, Father Lord, thank you, Father Lord, for everything. Oh, marvelous is your name, Father Lord. And when you lift up your name, Father, when we call upon your name, Father, everything is there for us, Father. And you answer our prayer always, Father Lord. Thank you for us giving opportunity to stand before you this morning, Father Lord. Glorious be on your name, Father. We thank you for everything, Father Lord. In the name of our Father, in the name of Jesus, Father, this Lord, in the morning. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord.
Come on, give a clap offering to the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. You may be seated now. Hallelujah. Amen. Ireland belongs to Jesus. Amen. Ireland belongs to Jesus. There's a lot of prayers that has been offered these days. Even yesterday evening, all the young people. Hallelujah. Amen. I had a fantastic time with them. And they have been praying and interceding for the nation and for the churches. It's an amazing, the heart of the young people. Amen. Longing for the nation. Hallelujah. Amen. In Jesus' name. And there is one more thing. Even the churches together, they are planning in 2 weeks' time. Amen. There is a prayer meeting together in the boxing stadium. I'll bring the detail if anybody wants to join. You can do that. Amen. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Our God is good?
All the time.
Yeah, man, it has been like a long time that, you know, I didn't see you all. Hallelujah. Amen. Because it's a family we love to see every day. Hallelujah. Amen. In Jesus' name. It's good to have Sister Hepzibah's daddy back in our midst. Let's put our hands to welcome our elder brother in Christ. Amen. May God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen.
came to support the daughter and grandson and son-in-law in Jesus' name. May the Lord bless them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of God Almighty. Let's look into the announcement this morning. Amen. Hallelujah. We'll be back to our care group this week. As Easter week, we are given break for everybody. So this week, Tuesday, we'll start our care group back. Please, we attend you to that. Amen. If anyone, you want to open your house in any new area, please just let us know. Amen. So it's important that we come as a family to edify in God's word. I thank God for the lessons that has been prepared by our Bible teachers in the church. I thank God for Sister Stella Gardswill and Brother Jason preparing the church in the area of gifting of teaching in Jesus' name. May the Lord bless them. Hallelujah. Amazing dedication by them. Hallelujah. Even they prepared the baptism group also. Amen. Teaching them in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. And tomorrow early morning we'll have our Google Meet, our weekly Blessed Week prayer meeting. It is from 5 to 6, so please try to be a part of that and start the week from the Lord. It is important. I know some of you love to sleep, but hallelujah. Let not your soul sleep in that time. Get up and be connected. Hallelujah. Come on, look at your neighbor and say, be connected with the Lord every day. Be connected with the body of Christ every day in Jesus' name. Amen. And Wednesday, the house prayer will be in Brother Anish and Sister Darshini. Their house, so we'll post the details. So please, if you're close by and if you're free, please be a part of that Wednesday prayer meeting. Hallelujah, the house prayer meeting. Thursday morning, we got a healing and prayer freedom prayer meeting from 10 to 12. That will be in the church building. If you're free from your work, please be a part of that and receive and stand on the gap for others. And we have been seeing a lot of results coming through that, particularly that prayer meeting. Hallelujah. Amen, in Jesus' name. So this Friday, we'll have a Friday prayer meeting also from 7 to 8:30. And Saturday, this is the second Saturday of the month, so we will go over evangelism. Hallelujah, evangelism team. They will organize for the evangelism on Saturday morning. And Saturday evening, we will have our Tamil service of this month. So those who can understand, please be a part of that at 5 o'clock. Hallelujah. Those are the announcements. May the Lord bless all the announcement in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of God. Amen. So now this time we want to honor our beloved brother Blaise as he has celebrated his 50th birthday. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Yesterday, in the name of Jesus. Amen. Play that, please. Amen. Look at that. This is this building where you are sitting. This is what we converted, how it was. You know, when we took, there was nothing, just a four wall. And the Blaze, he worked. There's a lot of days without getting any payment. He dedicated himself. Hallelujah. There you can see Brother Samson, Brother Sai also. Come on, say hello to the church, please. Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. If you can stand, we would like to pray for you. Amen. Amen. Give that flower. Pastor Gospel, please. Yeah, hand over to him. Amen. We want to bless him in Jesus' name. Not only that work, in always, brother has been ready to help. All the tiles in the kitchen and all the floor and the wall, everything is done by him freely. Hallelujah. And even recently, the glass has been replaced by him. Amen. I thank God. You know, some of you have a gift of teaching. Amen. Some of you, you might be serving in the children's ministry. Some of you in the prayer team. But God has brought somebody even to contribute something in the building area. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. You can hand over that in Jesus' name. Come on, clap for the Lord. Amen. Let's pray. Hallelujah. Father, we pray for our Lord God, your beloved son. We thank you, God, my Lord, from the birth until now, that your grace was sufficient for him. That your God, my Lord, you renewed his strength, and your Lord protected him from all the harm. and you have brought him, Lord, into the marvelous salvation of our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you, God, that he is able to live and dwell under the shadow of God Almighty. Thank you, God, for granting him, Lord, the 50th birthday on yesterday. We, Lord God, we celebrate with him for your glory, my God, my Father. The name that's the name of all names. The power of all power. The coming year is a year. We declare over him the year of prosperity and good success. In the mighty name of Jesus, that you will grant him, Lord God, a long life. In the mighty name of Jesus, according to Psalm 128, to God, my Lord, that he will see his children's children, and he will see the peace of Jerusalem in the mighty name of Jesus. We bless, bless in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit of God Almighty. In Jesus' name we ask this prayer. Amen. Amen. God bless you. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Our church, we practice, you know, wishing them for birthday or wedding anniversary. If anyone of you, you're not having your detail, please hand over your detail to Sister Marilyn. And some of them, sometimes they give instruction not to post their birthday wishes. So we have no right to, when they say, we cannot force. So sometimes it might be noticed in the group that we did not put their, you know, wishes or a blessing. It is their personal instruction given to the church not to post. That's the reason we did not do that. So it's nothing. So as much as we know the information, we'll be posting. Hallelujah. But when they say that, we cannot force. So that we have no right. Hallelujah. Amen. That's why you might be noticed some of the names are not coming on the church group in Jesus' name. Amen, amen, hallelujah. And we have the customs in the church also to honor the elders, amen. When elders, they celebrate their birthday, we want to bless them in Jesus' name. And today, we got Brother Samuel and Sister Bobby's, you know, mother in our midst. She's celebrating her birthday, which is the elder sister of my wife, amen. We want to bless her from the church, if we can bring her, hallelujah, amen. Sister Stella, please. Hand over the flower, amen, in Jesus' name. You can go there and hand over. We will pray for her, amen. Can we all stretch our hands towards her, amen, in Jesus' name. And let's pray. Heavenly Father, we bring, Lord God, this dear mother in your hands. The name that's the name of all name. The power of all power, God, my Lord, this is a day that the Lord has made, that we will rejoice and be glad in it, to King of glory. We bless, Lord God, my Father, this dear mother. Lord, my God, thank you, God, for the grace and mercy. Thank you, Lord, for the blessings upon her life, O God. Thank you, God, that you helped her to see her generations, O God, my Lord, my Father in heaven. Thank you, Lord, for bringing her to stand on the gap, praying and interceding, even for this church and for the nation, O God, my Lord, my Father in heaven. We pray that you will renew her strength. You will keep her safe under your mighty wings, O God, my Father in heaven. As she's celebrating her birthday today, we speak a blessing, O God, as a church. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit of God Almighty. In Jesus' name we ask this prayer. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. Let's all stand in the presence of God. We're going to take our offering and tithe and prepare ourselves towards God's word. Hallelujah. Amen.
For the royal die.
We crown you, God, with our very best to God, my Lord, with all our praises, with all our adoration, with all our offering and tithe and everything that we could able to offer this morning. Father, I pray the Lord God, that Lord, my Father, accept this offering and tithe as people of God, they given unto you physically and through the bank. I pray that you would receive it sanctified, use it for your divine glory, my God Almighty. We look unto your throne of grace, for according to your word, God, my Lord, that you will open the windows of heaven and you will outpour your blessing, that their storehouse will overflow in the mighty name of Jesus Christ, O King of Glory. I speak a financial breakthrough upon many of the people of God. I speak, Lord, the richness of heaven will come upon your beloved ones in the name of Jesus. They will not lend, Lord, they will be a givers in the mighty name of Jesus. They will not borrow anything, O God, my Lord. I declare and decree, they will become a channel of blessing, O God. The hands will be a blessed hand in the mighty name of Jesus. Speak to us this morning. Let your word will come with the heavenly richness and the deeper revelations of God, my Father. We come against every stronghold, every powersome principality, every spirit of judgmental, everything that stand against the service, against the sermon. We bind and arrest and demolish and destroy them now in the heavenly realm in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You take authority, O God, my Father. We give you all the glory and honor and adoration to you, God, my Lord. Jesus Christ, almighty and blessed and wonderful name, we ask this prayer. Amen. 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 Hallelujah. You may be seated now. God is good all the time. Amen. Hallelujah. We serve the good, good God. Amen. Good and mighty God. Hallelujah. He is wonderful. He is glorious. He is marvelous. He is mighty. Hallelujah. Amen. His love never ends in Jesus' name. Amen. How are you all? Are you all fine? Amen. Come on, everybody shout, I am fine in Jesus' name. Let the devil hear that. Hallelujah. Amen. Come on, shout again, I'm doing well in Jesus' name. Come on, say it again, I am excellent in Jesus' name. Shout in a way that I am marching on in Jesus' name. Come on, shout again, I am not tail, I am the head in Jesus' mighty name. I am blessed in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Clap for the Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. I don't know why I have done that one. Amen. Hallelujah. Maybe the Lord wanted to do that for the devil to hear that in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Even your own self. Amen. In the name of Jesus. This morning, as we have been coming out of the Good Friday and Easter, amen, all the season is over. Children are getting ready for the school. Amen. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Yesterday, there was one word that really touched me when there was a young preacher. She was ministering and praying for the nation. And literally, she was praying for all the young people, those, I believe that those of many of them, they may finish the college or they're in the college, and there's one word says, declare over them. God did not send you to the college and the schools just to come out with a certificate. Hallelujah. If you're not win a single soul from your college or the schools, then the certificate is no use in the sight of God. Hallelujah. God sent you to that field for a mission. Amen. So I thank God for the heart, you know, that really encouraged me to receive the revelation. Hallelujah. I would like to encourage all of the young people, even the working people, you know, the workplace you are in, not to just get some money. Amen. You're there just to win souls. Everywhere we go, as St. Paul, he says, in season and out of season. Hallelujah. Amen. That's not my message today. But again, it's connecting with that in Jesus' name. Today, we're going to meditate on God's word on the title, Heavenly Calling with Heavenly Power. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody repeat up to me. Heavenly Calling with Heavenly Power. Heavenly calling with Heavenly Power. Amen. Hallelujah. When you are recruited for a company, the company, when you are assigned for a job, the company will make sure that all the facilities there for you to achieve the work you need to carry forward. Amen. Hallelujah. So when God Almighty hears called you and me for His great mission, for His great purpose, for His great calling, He will not just leave you to struggle yourself, but God is God who has released His power also for you to accomplish the little mission or a big mission the Lord has given. There is nobody in the Bible, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Even my mic does not like what I want to release today. Amen. Hallelujah. I put something greater in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. So, you know, there is nobody in the Christian life that you are just an ordinary person. Every single one is called by God. Every single one is given mission for them. Every single one, you have a target. You have achievement. You have greater plan of God. That's what Jesus say. There's one God, 5 talents, and another God, 2, another God, 1. And the one who has given, the expectation of Him is what? That you begin need to multiply it. We need to multiply it. Hallelujah. There is nobody, Jesus mentioned, somebody got 0. Is it mentioned in your Bible? Amen. Is anybody's Bible is mentioned someone got 0? Hallelujah. Every single one got a talent, and the expectation is you need to multiply. And there's 2 group of people, they multiplied, and 1 person did not multiply. God knows he is weaker and lazy. That's why He has given just 1 talent. Even that 1 talent He could not multiply. He went and hid it. Hallelujah. And what is the statement? What is the title God is giving for that person? Wicked generation. Wicked. Hallelujah. And lazy. Amen. So, you and me are redeemed by the precious blood of Jesus. And we are moving under the glorious resurrection power of the Lord Jesus Christ. And for what? Not to just to enjoy yourself. My beloved people of God, the Bible says, we are the light to the world. We are the salt to the earth. That means you are called to bring the light of God wherever there is darkness. You're called to bring the flavor of salt wherever there is no flavor. That is a plan and purpose of God. Whether it's your working place or whether it's a school or college or your neighborhood. It is very, very important. And that's why God is a God who has released His power. That's what we're going to see. What kind of power you received. Amen. Hallelujah. And I'm going to connect with you. You know, after the resurrection, what has happened for the disciples? We know they were filled by the fear and all that. But what is the statement of our Lord Jesus Christ before He could able to go into heaven? Amen. And before that, I can go to the New Testament. Initially, in the beginning, we know the Lord God Almighty has created the human. He has created Adam and Eve. And what He did do? After He created everything, all the creation that you can see on the earth, after creating everything, in the end, He has created the man and the woman. He was well respected. He has prepared everything. Like you go to the restaurant and the meal is already prepared for you. All that you need to do is just go and sit down and eat yourself. And pay the bill in the end. It's like that. You do not contribute anything to go to the kitchen or to buy the things or to add anything, or you know, the food is already there. So such a way the Lord God Almighty has created Adam and Eve. And as He has created them, you know, before He could able to create them, everything else was prepared. And after He created the human, the Bible says in the next chapter, it says the Lord rested in Genesis chapter 2. In the beginning, we can see the Lord in the 7th day, He rested. When did the Lord rest? When He created the human, not in anything else. So when He created the human, He was
he was his expectation or his, you know, or his plan was to rest himself. He know that very well. He understood, or his plan was the man will handle everything in behalf of him. The Bible says in Genesis chapter 1 verse from 27 to 28. And listen carefully. Now it is a plan of God concerning you and me in the beginning, or the first Adam and Eve. So God created man in his own image. Whose image? Whose image? Whose image? Come on. Whose image you are created by? Amen. God Almighty. Hallelujah. So don't ever say that you're not beautiful. You're not worthy enough. When you're saying that, you are blaming the Creator. Is that right? Amen. When you say you're not beautiful, you're not intelligent, you're blaming the Creator. Hallelujah. If some product that comes from a factory, and if the product is not functioning well, who you will blame? You will blame that brand. You blame that factory, isn't it? Amen. Where is the factory you came from? Even though you came from your mother's womb, but there is a plan of God. Hallelujah. That's a purpose of God. Hallelujah. God has ordained you before your mother's womb. God knows you. Book of Jeremiah says, I know you before you could able to form in your mother's womb. Hallelujah. So the Bible says you and me, we are created in God's image. The image of God, he created him. Male and female created him. Why he has created? The verse 28, it says, and God blessed them. After he created, all that God can do is what? Blessing. All that your God has concerning you is what? Blessing. Only a few people? Blessing. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, church. Awake. Oh, no. You're not here to receive some, you know, a theory sermon. This sermon needs to impact you today. The way you respond, hallelujah. The way you receive, it is going to bring, amen, a breakthrough, hallelujah. A touch of God, something going to happen. Come on, shake your neighbor and say, be awake and receive what God is keeping for you today. In the name of Jesus, hallelujah. Amen. If the person is not responding, come on, just give a little bit. Amen. Hallelujah. Whatever he can do. And make sure that person is opening the mouth and receiving the blessings of God today in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Amen. Blessed be his holy name. Thank God for that. Amen. So all that God has concerning human, the first thing is what? He blessed them. And then he said. First he blessed, then he spoke. First he blessed, then he spoke. What did he speak? Hallelujah. Why he blessed? Without his blessing, nothing that you can do. Hallelujah. So that's why before he can speak, he blessed them. Hallelujah. He released a blessing over them. Young people, small children, it is important you receive a blessing from elders, from your parents. Hallelujah. Their blessing has a value. That blessing has a power. That blessing will remain on you. And that blessing will create something on you in Jesus' name. Open the door for somebody there. Hallelujah. Amen. In the name of Jesus. God bless them and said unto them. What is that he said? Be fruitful and multiply and replenish on the earth. Subdue it and have dominion over the fish and the sea, over the flow of the air, over every living things that moveth upon earth. Hallelujah. So all these things can happen. How does that happen? By receiving the blessings of God. By receiving God's blessing. Hallelujah. You want to multiply, you need a God's blessing. You want a power and authority, you need God's blessing. You need, hallelujah, you need to subdue something, you need God's blessing. God has blessed them and God has given them, hallelujah, the word that what all they need to do, fruitful, multiply, replenish the earth and subdue it. Subdue means whatever come against you, you have the authority to subdue it. Whether it's a sickness, whether the plan of God, some other forces trying to stop you. Hallelujah. Amen. I wish Adam and Eve, they subdued the power of Satan that time when the Satan came to tempt them. Hallelujah. But they forget about that, and they did not do that. Amen. You and me, we have the power to subdue every plan and work of the devil in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. My beloved people of God, I'm highlighting here, in the beginning, God has given them the power to fulfill the mission and the vision and the work of God in all the days of their life. But they enjoyed everything and they forget about the power of God. That is what happening in the Christianity today. You are saved by the precious blood of Jesus. You are baptized in the water. You are spirit-filled. But one thing always remember. The Bible says be vigilant. Be vigilant. Be vigilant. Be understand that you need to subdue the power of darkness so that you will have the victorious Christian life. You will not put down yourself. You will march on in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We can see on the earth only the human, they are doing a lot of things, isn't it? They are doing research even in this moon, in the sky, in the sea. They could able to create the ship and in, you know, many technologies and everything. Where does this all started from? It is given by God. It is not just a science, my beloved. It is given by God. God did not give these words to the animals. That's why animal could not dominate, do any technology. God did not give this promises to the tree and anything else. That's why they're not able to do it. But God has given this promise for the human. Hallelujah. Because God has released the human able to do lot of multiplication, lot of, you know, hallelujah, technology they could able to bring. It's all given by God. But they put a name called science and they're disbelieving on God. Hallelujah. They're forgetting about who is given them. Amen. Today I want to highlight that you and me, we need to have the power of God, which Adam and Eve, they lost and they handed over to the devil. Hallelujah. And the Bible says as we move forward, the Bible says in Matthew chapter 28, verse from 18 to 19, Matthew chapter 28. Verse from 18. And Jesus came and spoke unto them. Come on, again, say Jesus spoke. Jesus spoke. Saying, all power. Come on, everybody say all power. All power has been given unto me. God is remaining because that power was lost by the first man and woman. And Jesus, after his resurrection, he coming and visiting his disciples and he's reminding them all power that has been given unto me. Hallelujah. So that what you need to do, amen, unto me in heaven and in earth. All power Jesus hold it in heaven, on earth. Amen. He came and he destroyed the work of the devil on the cross and he took the power back which the Adam and Eve, they lost it. He took the power back. Those who have Jesus inside of them, they have that power back. But the world does not have that power, my beloved. The world is still struggling. The world is still aligned with the power that has been lost. That is why the devil is destroying the world like anything. Because they have that power is not there. They are lost it. When you and me receive Jesus inside of us, as Jesus become our personal Savior and God, that power has been restored. You have become a new creation. The world things are passed away. Your helpless situation is gone. Hallelujah. Your sick situation is gone. Your powerless situation is gone. You have become a power bank. Come on, touch your heart and say, I am a power bank. Hallelujah. I am carrying the power of heaven. The power of heaven is inside of me. Hallelujah. That's who Jesus came. Amen. All power has been with me. He restored every power on the cross. And he said, it is finished. He took it back. He took it back. And whoever believe on them, we believe on Jesus Christ, he is releasing that power. Hallelujah. And verse 12, verse 19, it says, 28:19, go ye therefore. Why that power? Jesus has it. We need to go and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. The highest name the Lord has given you and me to handle it. When you are teaching somebody, when you are baptizing them, somebody, you are representing, you have the stamp to put over them. Hallelujah. To baptize them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit of God Almighty. The mark of God is coming upon that person. And they will start to glorious in Jesus' name. And what Jesus said, go, therefore. Go means what? Some people, they take it mistake. Some people, they think, oh, I need to travel to that nation. What is the Bible says? Go unto all nations. Is all nations included Ireland? Is it Ireland comes under all nations? Yes. I thank God for those who are understanding. When any preachers comes and say, go, some people, they immediately, you know, try to plan for their trip. And in front of our eyes, people are dying and perishing and they're going to the hellfire. Who is responsible for them? My beloved, your neighbor not knowing Christ. Your neighbor, they are on the way to the hellfire. Your neighbor, the people, those who live in the city, 99%, they are under darkness. Instead of you stand on the gap for the nation where God has planted you. Go means go out of your comfort zone. Go out of your selfishness. Go out of your house. Knock on the doors of your neighbor. Share the gospel. Give them a cup of tea. Invite them. Give some gift and share. Put a leaflet. Pray for them and intercede. That is called go. That's what the Bible says. First you will be my witness for Jerusalem. First start from Jerusalem. Hallelujah. The next door need to be our doorman, our target first. What did the disciples do when Jesus said go? Did they go immediately to the other nation? They went to the temple street. They went on the street. They went to the religious people. They started to share the gospel. They brought the revival in Jerusalem first. Jerusalem was shaken. Is your Jerusalem is shaken? What are we doing? Are we hiding our talent somewhere? 5 days in a week you are going and visiting your office. How many years? The same place you're working. What is the fruit you brought concerning heaven, my beloved? You have the power of heaven. You do not need to do on your own strength. Let church rise up in these days. Let us not hide the resurrection power of Jesus again under the tomb. He is no more in the tomb. He is risen. He is risen for what? For world to be get saved. For world to be get know that his risen power. Who will go? Who will go and tell? Hallelujah. God is not based on your word. My beloved people of God, the Bible says, you will open your mouth, the Holy Spirit will speak through you. Are you ready to open your mouth for your neighborhood, to your colleagues, the people we visit every day? Hallelujah. Do that in the name of Jesus. We cannot leave our neighborhood and try to catch a flight and go to another country. Sometimes I feel sorry for the preachers traveling. You know, if they come with a special purpose and mission, that's good. To edify the body of Christ, to release the prophetic gift. God speaks, that's okay. Hallelujah. It's important that we know when you're under a leadership, under a church, whatever the vision or leading you get, it's good to pray with the man of God, to pray with the shepherd God is keeping over you, to get confirmed. If it is truly by God, you know, God will not operate to the, through your man of God in a different way. The peace will be released in the body of Christ. So first mission is what? First mission field is what? Jerusalem, Judea, hallelujah. With what you're going? With the power of heaven. Come on. Everybody say, I have the power of heaven. I have a power of Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. We need to have a humbleness heart when God visits us. That's why I say, go and consult the man of God. When we set our eye upon people, we become disappointed. When you become set your eye upon God, there's plenty of divisions these days. Plenty of different ideas, plenty of different visions and seasons. Hallelujah. What is getting disturbed? The body of Christ. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Christ will build his church. The gates of hell cannot prevail against it. Come on, my beloved people of God. I'm standing here and talking to you as a fatherly figure in spiritual atmosphere. If you receive any revelation, any visions, don't hold it until the very end that you feel something different. Come in the beginning and share. Get prayed. We are here to edify the body of Christ. We are here to reach out the souls. No other target, nothing else. No other target. Hallelujah. I appreciate. When God visited Moses, listen what Moses says in Exodus chapter 3, verse from 10 to 12. When God visited Moses, I know these days we have been hearing so much about Moses. I know there is something the Lord is going to do through Moses in this church to the nation, to the city of Dublin, to the nation of Ireland. We are going to deliver the people, those who are under bondages of the devil, hallelujah, into the worship mood, into the worship place, into the heavenly place, hallelujah. Those who believe, come on, clap for your hand and appreciate the Lord in the name of Jesus. Uraba sadala bukula baba balandira. Hallelujah. Exodus chapter 3, verse from 10. The Bible says, the Lord visited and the Lord is speaking. God said to Moses, come now therefore, and I will send thee unto Pharaoh, that thou mayest bring forth my people, the children of Israel, out of Egypt, out of bondages. Who is speaking? Almighty God, the creator of the heaven and earth. Almighty God is visited Moses. He can have a pride inside of him. Oh, I have been visited by God. I heard the voice of God. He can immediately go and he can try to fulfill the mission of God. But what did he do? He humbled. God is looking for the humble people today. Hallelujah. Whether a little thing or a big thing to fulfill, God is looking for a humbleness. Listen carefully. The next word he says, verse 11. Moses said unto God, who am I? Come on, everybody, touch your heart and say, who am I? Who are we before God, my beloved? Who are we? Spiritual prideness. Spiritual arrogant. Hatred, disunity. If we have this kind of nature, who I am, those kind of things will not harm. Moses can easily say, oh, I have a good experience. I was in the palace for 40 years. I studied everything. I know everything concerning the palace. I know everything concerning Israel people. I know everything concerning Egypt. He can easily say that. But he put everything, nothing before God. As St. Paul, he says, I consider everything not, I mean everything has nothing to gain Jesus. When it comes to God, our experience should be nothing. Our knowledge should be nothing. Even the gift that is operating, you cannot boast about the gift. Gift is given by God, my beloved. Every grace is given by God. I always say that, I said a few times, the Lord used Brahman, Pastor Benihin, so mightily one time. He was on the stage. Immediately the pride spirit came inside of him. And he said, because I'm standing, people are falling. Mighty miracles are happening. And the Lord said, my son, it's not because of you. The people, they are praying under this stage. Because of their prayer, I am moving so gloriously. If we can, I can take the Holy Spirit from you now, nothing will happen in this crowd. And he cried before God. He remembered Psalm 53. He cried, hallelujah, do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Every Christian, my beloved people of God, any nature, any vision you get, any level we might grow, we need to say, who am I? If we continue to say that, who am I? The Lord will continue to lift you up because there is no credit in you. Hallelujah. Let that nature come upon us in the name of Jesus. When Moses said, who am I? The Lord has declared and decreed, this is the right vessel who can deliver the Israel people out of Egypt. Amen. Whoever is here, if you have that nature, my beloved people of God, to lift the hands of each other, and considering yourself nothing, amen, the Lord will start to use you so gloriously, so mightily, beyond your understanding, not with your own strength, not with your own power, but with the power of heaven that will accompany you, and it will do unusual things, which only God can do it in your life. Those who believe, clap your hand and appreciate the power of God. Everybody shout with your amen, Lord wise, who am I for you to consider me Lord? Hallelujah. That humbleness nature we should have. And the Lord himself acknowledged about Moses. If God is giving witness for us, people can give a witness. Preacher can give a witness. But we need a witness of God. We need a witness for God. May the Lord give us that witness. Hallelujah. Again, the Bible says in Mark chapter 16, verse from 15 to 18. He said unto them, go ye unto the world and preach the gospel to every creature. Go. The Lord said, go unto the world, all the world. Is all the world including Ireland? Is it Dublin included in all of the world? It is misinterpreted today in the Christian field. Go means people immediately they will go home and pack their things and book the ticket. If one ticket we book, we can build so many churches in some area of this, somewhere in the world. Hallelujah. Even I know some of the people, they try to save their tithe and use it for the mission field. Where in the Bible is written, the tithe is belongs to where? Where you are eating your spiritual food for your local church. Mission pledge is different. If the Lord is leading you for to go for a mission, he will give you. He will give you. Because it's a plan of God, purpose of God. Don't misuse God's money on your own way because you want to travel. You want the people somewhere in the world to appreciate you. Hallelujah. Amen. In Jesus' name. Many people, they go and, you know, minister to the Christians in different part of the world. And they will say, oh, I visited this nation, that nation. So many nations. Have you visited your neighbor? Have you visited the people in your street? Have you visited your colleagues in your company? with the gospel of God. I'm not talking about your physical visit. I'm talking about the spiritual visit. Let that be our mission. The Lord said, go unto the end of the world and preach the gospel to all creations. Hallelujah. My beloved people of God, since the Lord saved me, this was my passion. Anywhere, if I go for the, you know, to the hairdresser, I will share the gospel. If I try to go to the, you know, if I go to the supermarket, I'll try to find somebody, I'll share the gospel. I know I'm telling the truth. Even in the middle of all the, you know, I used to get people and or supermarket, I will be sharing. And I have been praying every day for our neighbors. Hallelujah. By my visit to our neighbors, Sister Gloria is here. She become, amen, a prayer team leader for ministry of Jesus. Hallelujah. And we have been a target for many days for another family. And that family was going through a lot of difficulty, sickness. We have been knocking at the door for God to open. And spoke to them. And they said yes, but it was delay. It took almost a year. We have been praying without giving. Even I told Sister Gloria where we live. But by the grace of God, the Lord has opened the door about 2-3 months back for the care group. Every Tuesday, we are conducting the care group in a different sense, praying for that family, increasing their faith. And since Sister is not able to walk, she's on the wheelchair. But what we are doing, last through it 2 weeks, and we made her to explain her, hallelujah, we made her to understand her, that we are not having gold and silver, we all that we have is Jesus. And I was telling my wife and Sister Gloria to hold her both the side, as Peter lifted the lame man and make him to walk, hallelujah, on the temple street. And I was, you know, I was commanding them, come on, lift this sister, let us make her woman walk. We can able to see the big changes even the last week. She was putting her step forward, hallelujah. And she said last week, I know it's going to happen, it might happen slowly. I said, sister, it may not be happen slowly, but you know, for some people it will happen immediately, but some people it will happen slowly. Because the reason is, God is not only uninterested on healing your body. When you receive a healing, some people will run away from the salvation. So the important is that the Lord wants you to understand the teaching of God so that you will have a deep rooted in the kingdom of God. And after that, when you receive the healing, you will not run away. You will stand as a witness for Christ Jesus. That's what I explained. Hallelujah. I want to tell you, every Tuesday when we visit that house, we can see her face is smiling. Her face is so glorious. She's becoming more stronger and stronger. And when I prayed before starting the care group, the Lord spoke to me, next year by this time, she will start back her work. Hallelujah. I believe that the Lord is able to do that miracle, because we are not visiting our mission field with our own strength. We are visiting our mission field with a heavenly power. Come on, everybody shout, heavenly power. Anyone you visit, the heavenly power will visit them, my beloved. You have the calling of God to impart God's glory. Hallelujah. Believe that you are not just speaking. You are releasing the word of God. You are sharing the gospel. That gospel has a power. It can create the things out of nothing. In the name of Jesus, speak when you, by believing it. Hallelujah. When you are speaking, you believe that something will happen. Something will touch that person. Something will transform that person. Hallelujah. God Almighty, He will visit them in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. He has all power. He has all power. Hallelujah. And the Bible says from verse 16, he that believeth and be baptized shall be saved, but he that believeth not be damned. Verse 17 and 18. These signs shall follow them that believe. In my name shall they cast out devils. They shall speak the new tongues. They shall take up serpents. And if they drink any deadly things, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay hands on the sick and they shall recover. Come on, look at your neighbor, say, and look, did you believe, and is that happening for you? And ask the person, are you a believer? Are you really a believer? Hallelujah. Some of us are so helpless. Amen. If you have a title called believer, these are things need to be there. What are the things? When you lay the hands, sickness need to go. You need to talk in new tongues. Some of you might be having a question that why some people are talking in new tongues, which I'm not understanding. If you are a believer, you should have received this gift according to the Bible. Hallelujah. If you have a question, we will guide you through. Amen. You will subdue the power of darkness. You will deliver the people from the power of prison, from the principality. Because you carry the greater power, which is a power above all power. I believe and sense that ministry of Jesus, the Lord is taking into the dimension that we are moving under the glorious anointing of God. We are in a season. The signs and wonders will happen. Mighty miracles will take place. Sickness cannot stand by. Oh, demon cannot hold the people's life anymore. In the name of Jesus Christ, the people will not be spiritually blinded. The power of God will keep them and they will be delivered, they will be restored, they will be fruitful in the glorious name of Jesus. It's not by our power, it's not by our might, it is by the power of heaven, by the power in the Holy Spirit of God Almighty. Come on, everybody, raise your hand and clap unto God that He is able to do it in the name of Jesus, extraordinarily, abundantly, gloriously, whatever we can think. Hallelujah, He is able to do it. The same Jesus I can sense in my spirit. Jesus Christ is here in our midst. The Lord is here in our midst. According to His promise, He said, where two or three gather, I come down. He is here to perform His miracle. He is here to release His anointing. He is real. Amen. He is here to prove that He is God Almighty, that He is the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. The great that I am, that I am. If He can do the miracle in Jerusalem, He is able to do it, His miracle in your own Jerusalem, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift your hand and appreciate the power of God. No power that will hurt you, my beloved. You do not need to be scared. Hallelujah. If you are a believer, these signs need to follow. Don't be a sleepy Christian. Be a true believer. A believer needs to do those things. Then he will move to the apostolic ministry. Then he will move to the prophetic gift. Then he will move to the teaching gift. Amen. Any ministry you do, the signs and wonders need to take place in Jesus' mighty name. Hallelujah. Do it in a such a way. Whatever the assignment has been given for you, do it in a such a way in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. As Jesus was telling, the Bible says again, the Lord blessed them. Gospel of John chapter 20, verse from 21 to 23. Then said Jesus to them again. Come on, everybody say again. Come on, look at your neighbors and say how many messages you will hear. How many sermons you will hear? What is that happening inside of you? Is it not awakening you, my beloved? Hallelujah. When are you going to touch one soul from this, from the world and to bring them to the kingdom of God? Is it God's mistake? We sometimes pray, Lord, fill them the church. Hallelujah. Fill the empty church is a very easy formula. St. Paul, he says, Paul planted, Apollo poured water, the Lord brought the fruit. We don't do that planting and watering and we will expect God to bring the fruit. How does it happen without planting the seed and pouring the water, you can expect the fruit? How many of you are planting the seed of heaven to people's life? How many of you are praying for the seed that has been planted over them? How many of you are forgetting about the evangelism we did last time? How many of you are praying and interceding for the evangelism and the leaflet we have given, my beloved? Or you might be visited somebody on the street. You might be spoken. Did you take their name and you're praying and interceding? If you truly do, you will see the Lord will bring the harvest in the name of Jesus. The formula is so easy. Paul planted, Apollo poured water, the Lord brought the fruit. Without doing that, don't pray for the empty chairs to be filled. It's not going to happen. Target for the person. Whoever you share the gospel, bring their name into the feet of God. The demon will trample whoever is holding and spiritually blinded their eyes, and they will turn to God in the mighty name of Jesus. O Rabba Sadala Bokula Babalandira. We can see Brother Sai has been poured out himself in the media team. For all these years, isn't it? And Sister Liz is involved in the worship team and serving in different areas. They were not Christian. They didn't know the Bible. But there is one person called Brother Sharmil in the church. When he was in the hospital, he went and shared the gospel. He put the seed. And he asked us to pray that this person is there in the hospital. We prayed. And the Lord brought the harvest. Amen. Hallelujah. Who knows, by touching one person, that can bring up a great apostle, great prophet, great evangelist. Why they are not rising up? It's not a mistake of heaven. It is a mistake of us. Do it specifically. Target somebody, share the gospel, pray and intercede for that person continuously. You will definitely see the result, my beloved. Don't pray just there and here. Pray and target. When you wanted to hit, hallelujah, when David wanted to hit Goliath, he did not throw the stone into the entire army of Philistine. No, he threw the stone into straight into the neck. To the head of Goliath. There he destroyed, and the entire army has been defeated. Hit where you need to hit, so that you will see the harvest in the mighty name of Jesus. O Rama Sadala. Let your prayer room turn in such a way. When you get an opportunity to pray, pray, target, don't roam there and here. I always say to the people, devil will wait to make your prayer to be diverted. We have to be careful. That's what the Bible says. Be vigilant. Be vigilant. What you are targeting for. Hallelujah. A preacher went to the house to pray for a sick person. Maybe some of you heard that. Praying and praying. They asked us to pray for the sickness. And he was praying and interceding for all the nation, mentioning the nation's name. The end, he opened the eye, the person is died. And the preacher asked, when did this person die? And the family said, when you were praying for Canada, that's the time the person died. Hallelujah. Let not be our Christian life in a such a way. Pray and target and release the power into that area. The principality will be pulled down in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of God Almighty. Our God is good. All the time. Jesus said, Gospel of John chapter 20. Verse from 21, Jesus said unto them again, peace be unto you. As my Father has sent me, even so I sent you. There is no different. As Jesus came, you are also going. When you are marching on, you are marching like Jesus. That means whatever the miracle Jesus did, you are also able to do it. And Jesus said, more than that. More than that. As the Heavenly Father has sent Jesus, the Lord Jesus Christ he is sending. And verse 22, when he had said this, he breathed on them. Sometimes, because he was speaking again and again, this breath might be a blessed breath. Sometimes, you know, people will do the big breath. This person is not hearing, isn't it? It's a disappointed breath. But I believe that this breath is a good breath. Amen. Hallelujah. And say it unto them, receive the Holy Ghost. Receive the Holy Ghost. Where the Spirit of God, there is liberty, there is healing, there is freedom. Hallelujah. And Bible says, verse 23, whosoever sins you remit, they are remitted unto them. Whosoever sins you retain, they are returned. We have the power to bind and loose. If you command for that person to be repented from their sin, the power of God will be released and the person will be turned. The person will turn. There is authority. My beloved people of God, I can bring many, many testimonies. When things were not happening, when we took authority and prayed, things changed upside down. Amen. It is not our strength, because we based on the strength of God. The Lord has done it. Hallelujah. And again, the Lord Jesus Christ, he was telling them before he can go to heaven. Book of Acts chapter 1, verse from 6. It's a very familiar passage for us, but I would like to touch here. When they were come together, they asked him, saying, Lord, wilt thou at this time restore again the kingdom of Israel? Some of us, we are into crowd. We want the, you know, church to be filled. We want the people to be filled. We don't care about the presence of God. My beloved people of God, our focus is on numbers. Our focus is not on the presence of God. That's why you're not able to see the numbers. When you see the presence of God, when you are praying for the presence of God will draw the people, and you will see the revival fire will hit. Amen. We need God in our midst. God in our midst. Even only three people, they said, amen, whether our God will save or not, we do not care. But we know God is with us. They did not deny. They did not try to please the nation or the kingdom. They were stood for the Lord. And because they went inside the fire, they could able to turn the entire nation upside down. I want to tell you, my beloved people of God, if we are a small group of people, if we can stand for the presence of God to come down in every meeting we gather, whether it's a care group or gathering here or any meetings, hallelujah, if the presence of God will hit, I want to tell you, the foundation will be shaken, the doors will be opened, the chains will be broken. Hallelujah. The nation will turn to Christ Jesus. Pray for the presence of God. Seek for the presence of God. Ask for the presence of God. Look for the presence of God. Try to feel the presence of God. That is what we need. Hallelujah. That is what we need. He said, they asked, when are you going to restore? And Jesus said, he said unto them, it is not for you to know the times and the season which the Father has put in his own power. When you are praying, things may not be happening. But don't be discouraged. Is the season over? It's not your duty to decide the season over or not. It is in the hands of the Father. Continue to pray. Continue to push yourself down. Continue to be in the presence of God. You will see the power of God's manifestation in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Verse 8 it says, but you shall receive the power. Come on, everybody say power. Power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you. When you receive the power, when the Holy Ghost is upon you, you will receive the power. How many of you receive the Holy Spirit in this church? How many of you are sure that you have the Holy Spirit? Hallelujah. Amen. Do you have the power of the Holy Spirit? If you have the Holy Spirit, he is a powerful spirit. He owns the heaven and earth. He can do everything, anything. Hallelujah. Amen. I could able to command to the rain not to rain over my house. There was one time. Amen. I can share many testimonies. I was shopping nearby and I suddenly remember the clothes were outside. You know, when the rain comes in Ireland. I said, Lord, let not be rain beside my house. And I finished the shopping, I went. As I was going, I could able to see only on my oak compound there is no rain. And I went and took the cloth inside. Rain started to fall in that place. Hallelujah. If Joshua can stay to the sun, be still. You and me carry the power of Jesus. You and me, we carry the power of the Holy Spirit of God. You have the full authority, my beloved people of God. The name of Jesus. And we know, as Jesus said, when they were together, receive the power of the Holy Spirit. And you will be my witness, Jesus said. And they become obedience. And Acts chapter 2, we can see they were together with one accord in one place. And what has happened? Every single one received the tongue. Every single one received the power of God. Every single one were under the anointing of God. It's not God's mistake if we cannot receive the anointing of God. It's not God is delaying it. Hallelujah. You need to be connected with the mission of the church. You need to connect with the vision of the church. You need to connect with the worship leader. You need to connect with the preacher. Hallelujah. Don't be diverting. Don't be holding your mobile phone. Don't be thinking about something that what you will eat after that service. Hallelujah. I mean, now you think what is going to happen over you when you are thirst and hunger for the presence of God. God's glory will come upon you. 120, they gathered together in the upper room and they all received the Holy Ghost fire. My beloved people of God, why those kind of things are not happening these days in the church? Because people are diverted. We are not with one accord. Hallelujah. We need to make sure that you're connecting with the songs, you're connecting with the praiser, you're connecting with the worship leader, you're connecting with the preacher, you're connecting with your hallelujah church members together so that you will experience what others have. You will not go with empty hands. And when they received the anointing, what did happen? They first reached out Jerusalem. 3,000 people got saved. If you have the power of the Holy Spirit, the power of the Holy Spirit is not for some other nation. For you and me, we are called to save Dublin for Jesus. We are called to save Ireland for Jesus. We are called to turn this nation upside down in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of God Almighty. Yesterday, as I was in the meeting, the end of the meeting, there was one preacher. He came to me personally. I did not go for prayer or anything. He came and he said, the Lord is telling me to tell you. As Peter, he has given his boat for Jesus to preach. The Lord rewarded Peter with a full net of fish. The same way you are given this boat, the ministry of Jesus, facility for many ministry to come and conduct the meeting. The Lord is going to reward the ministry of Jesus with a full net of fish. Hallelujah. He said, you are going to see the harvest. The harvest is going to be truly plenty. Hallelujah. I can only hear 5 or 6 hands clapping for God. Is that all you're expecting, my beloved? No. Oh, don't be sleepy, Christian. It is not spoken by a man. It is spoken by the power of the Holy Spirit. Initiated to the preacher, and the preacher came and testified. Hallelujah. That is why this place is open for every ministry to come in, and they are praying and interceding and worshiping God. If we can look at our calendar, almost every month, 2-3 meetings. Until November, we have been booked. I'm sometimes wondering why all these people come into this little building. Where the presence of God, their people will be drawn to. And we are not into the area of demanding. We're getting some, you know, we have some standard of charging. But if some group they are not able, we will try to help them. Hallelujah. Because it's all about the kingdom of God. We cannot stop any prayer meeting because they don't have the money. It's not a business. Hallelujah. God will bless us. As they come in and pray, the presence of God will increase here. The glory of God will increase here. The power of darkness in the heavenly realm, it will be teared down, and we can freely move with the anointing of God in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. The Bible says, my beloved, that's why I said 120 days receive the Holy Ghost fire, and they have chosen just 7 people to serve the food in the church. Imagine every single one. You're filled by the Holy Ghost. You're filled with anointing. You're filled with the gift of God. Imagine how much more we can do. That was the early church. They selected 7 people to serve the food. And the Bible says in Acts chapter 6, verse from 6 to 8, whom they set before the apostles when they had prayed. And they laid their hands on them. Who laid the hands? Apostles. Even the people, they were praying people, they subjected under apostle. When you are a member of the church, be subjected under the overseer, under the pastoral role, under the leadership, so you'll be blessed in Jesus' name. And verse 7, the word of God increased. A number of the disciples multiplied in Jerusalem greatly. Come on, everybody say greatly. And great company of priests were obedient to the faith. Why this all happened? Because spiritual church, powerful church, let the power of God demonstrate upon every single one so that we can touch anyone in this nation, in the city, in Jerusalem. In Jerusalem, greatly people were touched. And verse 8, a person called, he's a chef. He's just a food preparing person. Are you like that? Are you not a preacher? Are you an ordinary person? He was an ordinary person. All that he knows is to serve God, serve the food for the people. Are you a person who is serving the tea and coffee? But see what has happened through him. Verse 8. Stephen, full of faith and power. Come on, everybody say, full of faith. Full of faith means what? It's overflowing. Full of faith and power, did great wonders and miracles among the people. Does it say Peter was full of faith and, full of faith and power? No, Stephen. Who was Stephen? Serving the tea and coffee, serving the food. He was full of faith and power. And what did he do? He did great wonders and signs. You cannot have any excuse. Oh, I'm ordinary. I'm not a pastor in the church. I'm not a worship leader. Everyone has received the Holy Spirit power and anointing. You need to have a full of faith. Move by faith. Move by the power of the Holy Spirit, not on your own power. Your power is nothing. Your power is useless. God's power is greater. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. In Jesus' name. Snega, can you go to the fridge and see if there is a egg? Just bring. I want to do a small demonstration. Hallelujah. If there is an egg, just bring. Do you have egg? No? I think the boys don't eat the egg. Okay. If you can find one, bring. Amen. You need more egg so you can more stronger for the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. As I was thinking about the Easter egg, does anybody know why the Easter egg is, they're gifting the Easter egg? Children, you long to get one, isn't it? Because it's chocolate? Is there any meaning for Easter egg? Amen. Nathan is sleeping under the anointing. Hallelujah. Is it that much poor, my preaching? Amen. Hallelujah, in Jesus' name, nothing, amen. See the egg, okay, we all know that egg, isn't it? We all know about egg. But if somebody cracked the egg from outside, what will happen? What will happen? The egg will? It will spill, it will crack, it will kill the life inside. The egg, every egg that carries the life, isn't it? If somebody smashed from outside, the life inside of the egg will be killed. Oh, there is egg. If you don't know, look at the screen, please. This is egg. Amen. In India, mostly you'll see the egg will be white color. I don't know, in different part of the country. It was big shock when I came to Ireland. How come? Is it spoiled egg? I was looking, you know, brown color egg. Because all my life I saw is, even in Saudi Arabia, I saw the egg was the white color. Suddenly coming to Ireland, longing to eat some egg, and I went to the shop, saw the egg is a brown color. Amen. Hallelujah. So this is an egg. If somebody smashed from outside, the life inside will be gone. If the egg smash the outer part of the egg from inside, what will happen? It will create a life. A life will come out of the egg. Are you all getting it? Are you all understand what I'm saying? When somebody smash outside, from outside, the inside life will be spoiled. But if the egg comes from inside and it smashed the outer portion, it create a life. It will become a chicken. It will become some other birds or something else. Hallelujah. I want to tell you, my beloved people of God, the pressure outside over your life, it will try to destroy you. It will try to pull you down. But you got a power of Jesus inside of you. You got a power of the Holy Spirit inside of you. That power need to come out, and it need to demonstrate. When it come out, it will create a life in the mighty name of Jesus. That is what the expectation of God. That is what I believe they are handing over the Easter egg. Hallelujah. Let's all stand in the presence of God. Let the power of the Holy Spirit come on, worship team. Let the power of the Holy Spirit come inside of you. Hallelujah. That you do not receive from outside. You don't, amen. I always say, don't run up to the preachers and show your head and just depend on the emotional blessing. Hallelujah. Go inside your inner room, your prayer room. Spend time with God. Spend time with the word of God. Spend time in prayer. Spend time with the Holy Ghost fire. Hallelujah. There is a life inside of you. That life need to be demonstrated to the city, to the nation. That's what the Bible says. You are the light to the world. You are the salt to the earth. You can create a flavor where there's no flavor. You can create a light where there is no light. May the Lord God Almighty use you in a such a way, in the mighty name of Jesus, that you and me, we will bring the life, life abundantly. You and me, we will bring the gospel of God and preach the gospel and create a life to the people, those who are going to the hellfire, in the mighty name of Jesus. You and me, your hands will be anointed, your mouth will be anointed. Then when you open the mouth, you will be filled with the power of God. You will be filled with the signs and wonders, in the mighty name of Jesus. As the song goes, release yourself and ask the Lord, my God, amen. Thank you, Lord, for helping me to understand today. May be the vessel with the full of power and full of, amen, faith, in the mighty name of Jesus. Sing and release yourself in Jesus' mighty name.
Bless the Lord, you heavenly host. Bless the Lord, all ye his angels, and let all the earth sing forth his praise. Come on, come on, come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name. Come on and bless him. Come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name. Come on and bless him. Come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name. Come on and bless him. Come on and bless him. Come on and praise his name.
Come on and bless him.
When I move my body, when I move my feet, when I open my mouth, then the darkness leaves. When I move my body, when I move my feet, when I open my mouth, then the darkness leaves. When I move my body, when I move my feet, when I open my mouth, then the darkness leaves. When I move my body, when I move my feet, when I open my mouth.
My praise is a weapon.
My praise is a weapon.
Your praise is a weapon.
My praise is a weapon.
Your praise is a weapon.
My praise is a weapon.
Your praise.
My praise.
Your dance is a weapon.
My dance is a weapon.
Your dance is a weapon.
My dance is a weapon.
Your dance is a weapon.
My dance is a weapon.
Your dance is a weapon.
My dance is a weapon.
My jump.
My jump is a weapon.
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 My jump is a
shout.
Weapon.
My shout is a 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 weapon.
My shout is a
weapon. My shout is a weapon.
Strongholds are coming down. Jesus be lifted high.
Jesus is lifted high.
Strongholds are coming down.
Strongholds are coming down.
Jesus be lifted high.
Jesus is lifted high.
Jesus be 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 lifted high.
Move our body, the darkness will flee. Hallelujah. That faith we need to have. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you, God, my Lord, that you ordained us, you anointed us, God, with the power of God to create a life where there's no life, to bring, Lord God, forth the excellence of God over this earth. I thank you, God, for speaking to us this morning. Let the Holy Spirit of God, that you will rain upon every single one. Those who heard in this building and through the online. I pray that you would release your divine glory. Your power, your anointing in the mighty name of Jesus. May the Lord God Almighty make every single one to understand that we are not alone. Hallelujah. The one who is in us is greater than one who is in the world in the name of Jesus. Bless your people, O God, my Father. Give us the grace to pray in a way we need to pray and intercede and see the result of it in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, I thank you, God, my Lord, that you have granted us in a wonderful and amazing moment of worship and prayer and listening your word, O God, my Father. I pray that every single one, O God, my Lord, that you will, Lord, guide them through. That they will, Lord God, will be full of faith and power in the name of Jesus. They'll be overcomer in the mighty name of Jesus. Guide us and lead us with the power of the Holy Spirit of God Almighty. Father, as we're going out, Lord, let your presence will accompany us, continue to help us to sense your presence in our life, in our house. Wherever we go, my Father in heaven, we love you, we worship you. I bless your people in the name of the Father. And of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit of God Almighty. We love you, we worship you. In Jesus Christ, almighty and blessed and wonderful name, we ask this prayer. Amen, amen. Come on, give a big love offering to the Lord. May the Lord bless you. Hallelujah. We have a blessed and wonderful week in Jesus' name. Amen.
Strongholds are coming down.
Strongholds are coming down.